Hello children, in the last part we did question answers of the chapter The Tsunami. We discussed them, and today in this video we are going to discuss the textbook exercises. So open your books and be ready with your pencils and let's get started. Then let's start working with language. Question number one, go through part one carefully and make a list of as many words as you can find that indicate movement of different kinds. And then you have to put them into three categories, like the fast movement, the slow movement, and neither slow nor fast. So this question is your homework. You have to go through part one again in the PDF file and find out the words which will fit in these three categories. That's your homework. So I'm moving on to question number two now. Fill in the blanks in the sentences below. The verbs given in brackets will give you a clue. Now every sentence has got a verb in the brackets, like tremble or confusion or relief, rescue, excite. These verbs are to be changed in the sentence. That is, their form will be changed when we are going to put. So let's see how we can change them. The earth trembled, but not many people felt the tremble will become tremors. Second, when the zoo was flooded, there was a lot of dash and many animals escaped into the countryside. The verb is confuse. What can you make of confuse here? Confusion. It'll be confusion. Next, we heard with dash that the lion had been recaptured. The verb is relieve. We will change the form and put the verb here. So it'll be, we heard with relief. Relief. The zookeeper was stuck in a tree and his dash was filmed by the TV crew. Rescue is the word. But even if we change its form, it won't change actually. The word here will be as it is. So it'll be, the zookeeper was stuck in a tree and his rescue, it'll be as it is, rescue, was filmed by the TV crew. Fifth, there was much dash in the village when the snake charmer came visiting. The verb is excite. So you have to change it into the proper form. There was much excitement. I hope you have noted down these words, which is why I am flashing on the screen. All right, let's move ahead. Question number three. You can see two columns given here, column A and column B. Now, if you read the sentences, they are more or less the same, but it's just that they have been put the other way round. Let's read the sentences. In column A, we have a sentence, Meghna was swept away. The same sentence is reworded like this in column B. The waves swept Meghna away. Next, Alma's grandfather was hit on the head. And in the column B, we have it differently worded like, something hit Alma's grandfather on the head. Similarly, the third sentence, 60 visitors were washed away. Part B will say, the waves washed away 60 visitors. Next, no animal carcasses were found. Do you remember carcass? Carcass is a dead body. Okay, now this same sentence has been reworded in column B like, people did not find any animal carcasses. Now these are two different categories. But what you have to see here is, you have to look at the verb in every sentence. Now here comes the concept of active and passive voice. Let's go through what is written in the book and then I'll explain you what this is about. Let's scroll to the next page and look here. Compare the sentences in A to the ones in B. Who is the doer of the action in every case? Is the doer mentioned in A or in B? Come back to this table again. Look at the columns properly. Now we are talking about doer. Doer. Who's a doer? The person who does the action. Okay. Now in column A, Meghna was swept away. What is the verb here? Swept. But it also has a helping verb, was swept. Where in the other case, the waves swept Meghna away. Now in this sentence, it is very clear who is the doer of the action. The verb is swept, the action is swept. Who is sweeping? The waves. So the doer of the action in this sentence is very clear. It is the waves. But it was not clear here. Next sentence. Alma's grandfather was hit on the head. Something hit Alma's grandfather on the head. Now here again in this sentence also, something. It's an indefinite pronoun. Something hits. That is, something becomes the doer of the action. Look at the next sentence. 60 visitors were washed away. Next, the waves washed. Now, if washed is the verb here, who's the doer of this? The waves. So here again, the doer is very clear. Come to the last sentence. No animal carcasses were found. Next, people did not find any animal carcasses. Who did not find? Who's the doer here? People. So in column B, you saw that the doer of the actions were very clear, like the waves, something, the waves, and people. These are the very prominent doers of the action. Now, in cases where the doer of the action is mentioned, they take the form of active voice. Let's read ahead. Notice the verbs in A. Was swept away, was hit, were washed away, were found. They are in the passive form. Now, how do you know whether a verb is a passive form? There are two things which you can see here. In this, or in every part, you can see that the verb, whenever it is in the passive form, it will always take the third form of the verb, that is the V3 form. And it will always have a helping verb before it. So if it is were only swept, it is not in passive form, it is in active form. But if it has a helping verb and it is in the third form, was swept or was hit or were washed. Can you see here? All these verbs are in the third form and they have a helping verb before it. They come in the passive form. And the sentences are in the passive voice. If you have such form, they are termed as passive voice sentences. And in these sentences, the focus is not on the person who does the action. But in B, in the column B, we just saw that we can have prominent doers there. The doer of the action is named. The verbs are in the active form. The sentences are in the active voice. Now look at the same table from different point of view. Now look here. In column A, Meghna was swept away. Alma's grandfather was hit on the head. 60 visitors were washed away. No animal carcasses were found. Now everywhere in all these sentences you can find the verb in the third form and being helped by a helping verb. So these are the sentences where the doer is not very important. There's not a proper mention of the doer, who is doing it, but it was done. So such sentences will be in passive voice. While on the other hand, in column B, you can see the verbs only swept. There is no helping verb before it, or hit, or washed, or find, or did not find. Okay. Now these verbs have the doer in front of it. Now in all these sentences, it's very clear who is doing that action. So when the importance is given to the doer, the voice will be active voice. Now I hope you understood what I discussed about those column sentences. Let's do this exercise now. Now look here, say whether the following sentences are in the active or passive voice. What do we have to remember? If it is in the passive voice, the verb will be in the third form and there will be a helping verb before it. But if it is in the active form, there will be no such case. Let's see. Someone stole my bicycle. Is the doer of the action clear here? Yes, someone is the doer of the action. So where the doer is clear, you have it in active voice. And that is why they have written A in front of it. This is an example given to you. Come to the second sentence. The tire were deflated by the traffic police. Were deflated. Just look at the verb here. Deflated is the third form of deflate. And it is helped by a helping verb, were. And in this case, the doer of the action is not clear in the first part. There is no, the importance is not given to the doer of the action. So this sentence will be passive voice. So write P here. Next, I found it last night in a ditch near my house. Where is the verb here? Found. Is there a helping verb? No. So, and is there a doer? Is importance given to the doer? Yes. The doer is I. So in that case, this will be active voice. Next, it had been thrown there. Had been thrown. The what's the verb here? Thrown. It is in V3 form. And it is helped by the helping verb had been. Yes. So it becomes passive voice. Next, my father gave it to the mechanic. Verb is gave. Can you specify the doer? My father. That means the doer is given importance. So it is active voice. The last one. The mechanic repaired it for me. What's the verb here? Repaired. But is there any mention of the doer here? Yes. The mechanic. So this also will be in active voice. Coming to the next portion, speaking and writing. These questions will be done with you in the class itself, but for your convenience or for the improvement of your own writing skills, you can try to do this at home. That's all in this lesson. Feel free to ask any doubts in the inbox of my video. And in my next video, I'm going to bring a poem to you, the geography lesson, and which is based on the same theme as this, on nature, on world, or the geographical aspects of Earth. Thank you very much and take good care of yourself.